See, in the last class we discussed about the web of science and what is called H index and impact factor, right? The research conventional traditional research metrics to evaluate the performance of research, let it be of an institution or individual or a journal. Okay, so moving on from that, today we are going to discuss about another citation and indexing database which is as good as web of science, that is Scopus database. Okay, all are having the same functions only, but the coverage is different. Okay, so we know what is Web of Science. So similarly, we are going to discuss about Scopus. So Scopus is again, it is a citation and indexing database. Remember that. Okay, and I have told you about what is citation, what is citation index. Please go through Web of Science database PPT for better clarification again. Okay, so Scopus, the owner of Scopus is Elsevier. Okay, so Scopus is one of the largest. It has more coverage when you compare to Web of Science. Okay. It is owned by Elsevier, whereas Web of Science is owned by Clarivate Analytics. Remember, it is not Thomson Reuters, it is Clarivate Analytics, Web of Science, and Scopus is Elsevier. So Mendeley, you know Mendeley, Mendeley is owned by Elsevier only. Okay, Mendeley is the product of Elsevier. Okay, remember that. It is free, Mendeley. So it is a multidisciplinary bibliographic database. You know what is multidisciplinary? It covers various disciplines, right? I think I have given an overview about multidisciplinary, transdisciplinary and interdisciplinary research with example, I think. So multidisciplinary, it covers different disciplines. Bibliographical database, you should remember only one thing. These databases, Web of Science or Scopus, they don't contain full text. They only contain bibliographical details. That is why it is called as bibliographical database. Remember, they don't contain full text. If your institution subscribes it, you will get full text, or else you will not get full text. Or if the article is available in open access format, you will get full text. Okay. So approximately 70, it is updated daily. 70% of the title are from North America only, and 20%, 21% of the indexed journals are bilinguals. Okay. And are not English. Bilinguals means that it will be in English, or it will be in English and also in some other language. Okay, 21%. Okay, okay. And these are the time span is around, what do you say, 1823. Okay, so these depending upon the subscription, the time span varies. Okay, so these are value added services. We saw in Web of Science also what is the value added services. When you register, you can see about EndNote, master journal search, everything like that you can see. And similarly, you can set up alerts and you can see saved searches also, right? When you have a registration. Similarly for Elsevier Scopus, if you register, you can see like this. You can see, you will access to another Elsevier product. So Mendeley is a product of Elsevier. There are different products. You can access other products also. You can access Scopus, you can access other products. Similarly, Scopus is not free, remember that. Okay. It is also a paid subscribed database only. And set up, you can alerts and you can personalize, edit your searches like we did in Web of Science. Same only. For that, you need to register. When you register, you will get these kind of value added services. And this is the home page of what you call Scopus database. The home page will look like this only. Okay, this is the home page. See the Scopus, and there are different search options, same as Web of Science. The interface is different. Okay, document search, you can document search by title, abstract, keyword, affiliation or author affiliation, language, ISSN, DOI, etc. Author search, affiliation search and advanced search. These are the different search options available. So now we will see what document search is all about. You are searching it by, what do you mean by document? Searching the type of document, right? Okay, title, you are searching the document by the title of the document, abstract of the document, keyword used, author, everything. Okay, so these are the different document searches along with their detailed search fields, right? Author title, authors, first author, source title, abstract, keywords, DOI, everything, right? So document types, there are different kinds of documents available, like conference proceedings, conference paper, review paper, research paper. And there are different meeting abstracts, everything is there, right? So you can search according to the type of document you want. So this is document search, and see, these are the different types of document, right? Article review, article in press, book chapter, note, survey. See, these are different types of documents. Again, I told you about, I'm not going in detail about these search tips actually. I will take a detailed class about this, okay, later, on the later part of the session, okay. What is, how to search effectively in internet as well as in database. These are the basic operators you will come along in all the databases, right? Boolean operator will be there, that is AND or NOT. And truncation symbols, wildcard symbols will be there, that asterisk symbol and question mark symbol, right? So that will be there. Okay, I will tell you the search operations and how to search in databases effectively on a separate session. So don't worry about that. Okay. So this is for keywords. You are searching for keywords in document search platform. So the keyword is what you call social deprivation with asterisk symbol. That is truncation. That means whatever meaningful English sentence can be formed after deprivation, deprivational. Okay, deprivational thoughts or whatever it may be, meaningful English sentence which can be formed using social deprivation will come along, which be included in the search. And they have used AND operator called smoking. So social deprivation in the keywords tab, whereas smoking should be in the article title abstract as well as in the keywords. See how they are refining it. Okay, that means they want social deprivation and smoking. They want the results to combine together. Okay, this is document search, and see these different kinds of operator. They are using AND or NOT. Okay, as well as wildcard and truncation. Right. So now they are going to click search. This search. You can always go through this PPT presentation for better clarification. So this is the search result. This is the results. So nearly 15 documents are there. Because of using all these filters, you got only 15 documents, right? So now we are going to see about this particular document. Only one bibliographical item with a detailed example. So this is the bibliographical item. Factors affecting infection after cranial fracture fixation. So this is what we are going to see. So this is the extra information. What is the extra information? Publisher detail, number of last column cited by, this is cited by information, view at publisher. That means if you click it, it will directly take you to the publisher's page. Who is the publisher of this particular item? It will take you directly, and related documents. Okay. Based on the references, shared references, you can see related documents, right? So then this will help you to create the exhaustive literature review. Okay, you can see related documents, shared references. That means they have sharing the same references. They have cited the same references. Okay, now we are going to refine it and process it. These are the refined process, right? Year wise, subject area wise, whatever we saw in Web of Science, we can do it in Scopus also, right? And document types. And source title, that is journal or conference or whatever it may be. So some further options is secondary documents. You can view secondary documents from reference list, patents, everything. And default, the default sort is the latest date. You can change the date also. That means you want publication recently, like 2019 or 20. So you can change it. Okay. So this is the full record, full details about the particular bibliographical item. See the name of the journal, and this is cited by whoever. In Web of Science, we saw cited in core collection, cited in all databases. Like that, it shows who has cited this paper. Like that, if you click them, it will take you to all these 13 members who have cited, right? And if you click on this particular mail icon, you can email the author. Sometimes in order to get the full text, if you email the author, they will send you. There is a possibility. And if you click on this brush icon, you can see the correspondent information. That is author address, author details, everything. This where he is working, his affiliation for this particular document. Okay. You can go through this PPT for better clarification. So this is the references. References show this paper's bibliography. This is the reference list of this particular paper. Which other papers this paper has cited, like that, okay? So you can get a detailed reference. When you click this, it will take you to the related documents, right? So information about the correspondent. I have told you about first author, last author, and correspondent author, right? So that is the author who is communicating to the journal, correspondent. It is a full detail. You can get the full detail. If you want to communicate with them, you can communicate it, okay? for research purposes. Searching for keywords two. One, we saw keyword one, right? So see here they are using and operator depression and eating disorder and human and anoxia or bulimia in keywords. Okay, they are combining two searches using and or operator. Okay, so this is the result they got, around 2635. So either you can save it, edit it, or you can get alert. See, again we are having analyze result option. This is in Web of Science we had, right? Same we are having it. You can get graphs, you can automatically save this image for further analysis, for writing a paper or something. So these are the different ways you can analyze: by source, by author, by affiliation, country, document type, subject area. So all, both the databases are same, only the coverage varies. Okay, in some journal it will include in both Web of Science as well as in Scopus. Some journals they will be only in Scopus, some only in Web of Science, depending upon the indexing coverage. Okay, so now you have to click select all or something. You can get a citation overview, right? View citation. You can see the citation overview of this and see the citation pattern. See, from 2010 to 2013, how the citation has remained, whether it's the same or increased or something. See the number of citations, right? So 544, that's why it is same. So document. So we are going to search for author. So this Kolle we searched in Web of Science also. Let's see now how many results we get in Scopus also. For all years, refining for all years. Okay. The author field. These arrow marks will help you to identify. This means you have to click this. This is search icon. So this is for the list of documents published by that particular author. Okay. So this is the author name. He has 96 documents indexed in Scopus. In Web of Science, I think he had 84. Remember 84. That means he has 12 documents extra in Scopus. So see, the H index will vary. In Web of Science, his H index will be different. In Scopus, his H index will be different. So when I told you about H index, it depends upon the data source. Here the data source is Scopus, right? For the same author. So remember that, okay? So locate a particular author. You can easily locate a particular author, right? So Garfield, Eugene Garfield, he is the developer of ISI, that is Web of Science. He developed the citation index. Remember that. So we are searching for Garfield, his papers in Scopus actually. So this is the Garfield. So there are similar Garfields, but you have to refine which one is correct. So this is correct. ISI, Thomson Reuters, he is the owner. So others are in McGill University. So you have to see the affiliation and you have to know the details about the author, because there will be different persons using the same name, right? So you have to select the appropriate person. So Garfield is the owner of Thomson Reuters. So he developed the citation index ISI. So you have to select the appropriate author. Okay. Then when you click it will take you to the details about that particular author, right? So he has around 206 author results. So you are grouped with the name variants. Sometimes it will be, what you say, it will be with Garfield E, Garfield comma E. So everything will be grouped accordingly. That is the problem. Sometimes in Central University of Punjab, while writing a paper, what we will do is, we will write as CUP. Some author will write it as Central University of Punjab. Some author will write it as CENT.UNIV Punjab. So all the things should be grouped together. All the things should be grouped together. So that everything comes under Central University of Punjab. It's like that, the names will be grouped. So that all the different combination of the same name will be grouped for a single result, right? So again, you are analyzing the author results, right? Author output. So this is by documents. This H index is 18 or something in Scopus. In Scopus, it is 18. In Web of Science, it will be different, right? So what are the co-authors he has published with? The combined H index for author is 18 for these authors. That is, the meaning of combined means the name variance. Na, there are different names told you, right? Both are same people only. They have combined the search results of two. Affiliation. Affiliation is you are searching for an institution. My affiliation is Central University of Punjab. Your affiliation is also Central University of Punjab. The place where I am affiliated, place where I am working is affiliation. So here they are searching for a particular university called University of Heidelberg. This is that again, there are different name variants, right? So you have to see which one is correct. So the first one is correct, and after clicking that, it will take you to the information sheet of that particular university. You can always refine it according to your requirement. Okay, search options, advanced search option. We all know different operators, and or, not, near, pre, and you can use different codes also. Affiliation, affiliation city, affiliation country, everything is there, right? This is a search box where you can combine different searches, title, area, and not in not terms and everything. So this is they are, in Web of Science, to identify the H index, we are citing by, we can sort from time highest to time lowest. Okay, similarly in Scopus also you can do it to find out the H index or to find out the highest cited publication, that is the most cited publication. Okay, so you can combine the, you can combine different results. In Web of Science we saw that, right? When you have an account, when you register, you can combine. Similarly in Scopus also you can combine different search results by using their search, using your search history. In case if you have an urgent work, if you are leaving tomorrow or today, means tomorrow if you come, your search will be saved actually in the history. For that you need to log in, same here also, and you can combine it. When you combine your search, new result will be coming. Okay, so this is all about what you call Scopus database. So these are some of the useful links. So please take a note of this. How to use Web of Science, their official training. How to use Scopus and everything, their official training. How to use EndNote, that is a reference management system. Okay, this is not free. It is similar to Mendeley and Zotero, but this is not free. Okay, remember. And these are the training and other tutorials and related materials. Please go through this for further clarification. Okay, thank you.